Hello, today I'm going to teach you how to create custom elements in Portal 2 Puzzlemaker. Yesterday I created a new test chamber in Portal 2. It looks like this. However, in any puzzle there's your intended solution, and then there's the way the players do. In this chamber, players might try something like this. That's not quite what I had in mind for this chamber. After some deliberation, I decided that some kind of fence placed around here and maybe here would effectively prevent the players from doing that. The fence would be placed in the map like the light panel, which can be adjusted in 8 different positions. This should be handy enough. To create the fence, we must use a tool called Hammer. You can find it here under the Tools tab in Steam by the name Portal 2 Authoring Tools. You can download and install it for free if you have the game. To begin, navigate to sdk:\content\maps\instances\p2editor, where all the existing Puzzlemaker objects are. Opening an existing object is a great way to start, and I did so by opening the light panel. The light panel is already oriented the way I want, and it will serve as a ruler for my little fence. First, I deleted the things that I don't need, the light source and the clip brushes. Next, using the block tool, I created a new solid, which is roughly the same size and same position as the light strip, but will be extended upwards for about 32 units, 1/4 of a Puzzlemaker wall unit. For the texture, I was looking for one of the black wall textures with tiny tiles in them, preferably something a bit worn looking, and I found this underground black metal wall that matches the requirements perfectly. After some resizing to desirable target proportions, I saved the creation as metalbump.vmf. Next, because it is not possible to add new items to the palette in Puzzlemaker, only replace existing ones, I had to find an item that I do not need. I settled down to the Aperture Science Pneumatic Diversity Vent. To change the items in the palette, go to directory portal2dlc2/scripts and edit the file editoritems.txt. In this file, find the item you chose to replace and check its palette position. For my Aperture Science Pneumatic Diversity Vent, the position is 350. Gotta remember that. Then find the item you chose as a model. In my case, this is the light strip. Copy the entire item and paste it near the end of the file, before the renderables section. Give your new item a descriptive type name. This will be used in your puzzle files, so it is very important that you choose a name that is unique and unchanging. Change the names that will be used in the user interface. Change the palette position to the one you took from the replaced item. For me, this was 350. In the instances section of your item, you will have to place the file name of your hammer creation. For me, this was p2editor/metalbump.vmf. Because my light strip uses the floor button item class to work around Puzzlemaker limitations, there are 6 of these models for each combination of a cube type and a wall type. For now, I'm using the same VMF file for each of them. Portal 2 must be restarted for it to read the updated editor items file. Now the newly added metal bump item can be added into the map, just like a light strip. Note that in the editor it looks like the item you copied, because we didn't create a new 3D model for it. Let's compile the map and see what was achieved. There it is, our little knee-height wall. Now let's see if it does what it was created to accomplish. Activate this laser and... Oh, now that's inconvenient. I bet it's just a millimeter short of blocking the laser or something. How about the other wall? It overlaps with the glass panel. I might not want that. It's nothing important, but the style, the style! Let's go back to the drawing board, which is the Hammer World editor. First, move the wall 4 units to the right, away from the glass panel. Done. Then we have to do something about that height. I'm going to add a little bump to the top of the wall. A very tiny bump. Maybe just 2 or 3 units tall. And just so it doesn't look too crude, round off the edges of that bump. Just some texture finalizations to do, and back to the puzzle maker we are. This time we can recompile the map right away. Portal 2 does not need to be restarted. Exhibit 1. The laser is now properly blocked here. Exhibit 2. The wall no longer collides with the glass. Mission accomplished. And that's how you make custom items in Portal 2. Thank you for watching, see you next time, bye!